Romans 6, 17 and 18, and then I'll go on to read 22. It says, But God be thanked that ye were servants of sin, but ye have obeyed from the heart a form of doctrine which was delivered to you, being then made free from sin, because ye became the servants of righteousness. So we are now the servants of righteousness. Amen.
Amen.
But now, having been set free from sin and having become slaves of God, you have your fruit of holiness. This is your life. Your life is holiness. And the end, everlasting life. So even after your life of holiness ends here on earth, you have eternal life. Amen. So you got double life. Amen. Glory to God. Let's go before Him. Lord, we thank You for life and life more abundantly. We truly appreciate You right now, oh God, for allowing us to live, for calling us out, setting us free, God, allowing us to be free from sin, free from iniquity, free from everything that ails our bodies. We give You honor and glory because You didn't have to do it, but You're such a good, good Father, such a gracious, gracious King that we just give You glory. We thank You. Have Your way with us. Have Your way in the service, oh God. Have Your way in the Word tonight. Edify us, strengthen us, oh God, and continue to let us grow more in You. And we'll be sure to give You all the honor and the glory and the praise because it is due only to You. And we thank You in the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
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 Come on, give God praise.
Hallelujah.
You know His word.
Glory to God.
To be praised. We're just going to welcome Him in this house. Just extend our hands to the Lord. Father, You are welcome here. We come here with no other reason, with no other purpose in mind than to bless You, to give You glory, honor, and praise. Hallelujah. We welcome You, Father. Come on, just begin to thank Him for being good today, for just covering you, for protecting you, for keeping you on that dangerous highway. We thank You, Lord, that accident could have been us, but it wasn't us, Lord. So we give You praise now for our life, for our health, for our being. It's in You that we live, that we move, and we have our being. You are welcome, Holy Spirit. We invite You in this house today. Hallelujah, Jesus. We glorify Your name. Hallelujah. Oh, we welcome You, Jesus. We invite You, Holy Spirit, to come in the room tonight. We invite Your presence. Dwell among us. Dwell among us. Let Your glory fill this house tonight, Lord. We need Your Spirit, God. Oh, Lord. We invite You in. We invite Your presence. You're welcome here. You're welcome here. You are welcome here. You are welcome here. You're welcome, Lord. You're welcome. Dwell among us. Dwell among us, Lord. We thank You for Your presence, Lord. Thank You for Your power. Thank You for Your love. Thank You for Your grace and mercy. Hallelujah. Come on, put those hands together.
Who am I that You would come and see?
Father, we will continue continues to understand that no weapon formed against us shall prosper, Father God, because that's your word, Father God. Father God, we're going to continue to pray for those that are weak in the mind, Father God, that's sick in the mind, Father God, that we want to pray for them that they will understand that your word is the truth, Father God. Your word is healing, Father God. Yes. Your name alone is healing to our body, Father God. Yes. So we call on your name, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
for all that you are doing, Father God. And Father, we're going to continue to praise you. We're going to continue to lift up your name, oh Lord God. Because, Father, without you, we are nothing, Father God. And we need you every step of the way, Father God. So, Father, we're going to continue to praise you. We're going to continue to glorify you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Able to be revived.
Yes.
Hallelujah, Lord. You don't leave us where we are. I thank you, Lord, that it is abounding grace's heart, the church of abounding grace, city's heart, the nation's heart, to be revived, Lord.
Yes.
Something's missing. We know it's something's missing, Lord. We need to be refreshed again in the name of Jesus. Lord, there is nothing like your spirit when it comes in like a flood, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, restore us, renew us, refresh us. Give us the mind of Christ in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, Father, that we will thirst and hunger after righteousness in Jesus' name and not after worldly things, Lord, in Jesus' name. Father, let that be the heart of this city, Father, to be revived in Jesus' name. And I pray, Lord, that they come to this revival that's coming up here at Abounding Grace. And I thank you, Lord, that lives will not only be changed here, but all over the city, in Shreveport and Bossier. And I thank you, Father, that it's just a chain reaction, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Do a new thing on the inside of us, God. Cause us to become new again, Lord. You are doing a new thing. Do you not perceive it? Hallelujah. I thank you, Lord, that you're making a way in the wilderness in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord, that our heart is for you and you alone, God. Put a new fire on the inside of us in the name of Jesus. Give us a desire to read your word. Give us a desire to pray, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Give us the baptism of the Holy Spirit, Lord. You said if we ask, that we'll have it in the name of Jesus. And it's all for the glory of the Lord, God. We want to be worthy, God, worthy of the calling that you have purposed us for in Jesus' name, God. I just lift up every one of us. I thank you, Lord, that that is our heart, Lord, and that we seek you first in your righteousness. We seek first the kingdom of God and your righteousness, and I thank you, Lord, that all these things will be added to us. And I thank you, Lord, that you are able to supply all of our needs, Father. As long as we have you, we've got everything. If we don't have you, we have nothing, God. You are the vine and we are the branches, Father. Help us, Lord. We are nothing without you, Father. We love you. And I thank you, Lord, that we will never be lacking in zeal, God. But I thank you, Lord, that we will keep our spiritual fervor in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Lord. Help us, Holy Spirit, to keep it in the name of Jesus and remind us of who we are once again in Christ. That we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. That we are the head, not the tail. That we are all above only. And we are never beneath. We are royalty in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord, for the revival that's going to happen right now.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray now. We thank you, Lord, that we speak that the mind of Christ be on the inside of us, oh God. And not just on the inside of us, but Lord, let us have the mind of Christ so we can go out and disperse the mind of Christ everywhere we go through your word, oh God. We pray that souls would be saved, oh God, that their minds would be renewed. Father, we cast down imaginations and every high thing that would exalt itself against the knowledge of Christ, the knowledge of God, and we speak now that they have a healthy mind. We speak now that they have the mind of Christ. We speak now that every believer and even every unbeliever that's being attacked by the devil, thank you that no weapon that formed against them, it will not prosper, it will not work. We speak now that they are, we call life, Lord. We speak life on the inside of them, in the name of Jesus, if not death, Lord. We speak now in the name of Jesus that they're more than conquerors. We speak now that they are healed, that they are whole, that they are delivered, that they are free from the hands of the enemy because of the price that Jesus paid. So we give you praise now and glory for your goodness, for your kindness, for your mercy, oh God. We thank you, Lord, because you've been awesome to us, oh God. Thank you for the sacrifice that you paid for us, that we may all be free in our minds. Thank you, Lord, that we have healthy minds, oh God. And we pray now even for the world, Lord, in America, oh God. We speak now even to the mind of America, Lord. We say now, we speak the word of the Lord be there, Lord. We speak that men and women would rise with the mind of God, which is your word, and that we would declare and we would speak your word, oh God, and cause a change to happen, oh God. A change that would bring you glory, that would bring you praise and honor, because truly you're deserving of it. And we give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Somebody shout to our great God. Come on, give a praise.
Oh,
Amen. So let's give Pastor Hollins a hand before he comes. And if you guys, as close as you can, we greatly appreciate so much. Pastor Hans.
Amen. Amen. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise. Oh, come on, give the Lord a hand of praise. Offering him our thanksgiving. Amen. How great you are. Our God is great. Isn't he great? Hallelujah. Yes, you are great. Yes, we love you. Yes, we thank you. Yes, you are merciful. Yes, we lift you up. Yes, we intentionally praise you. We're intentional about it, Lord. We're intentional about lifting your name up. We're intentional about living holy and righteous, being all that you can be. Father, you are our Lord. Thou art our Lord. Hallelujah. And we want to be led by you, directed by you, guided by you in our everyday affair, Lord. In Jesus' name. God, we thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for touching this church. Thank you for touching our hearts, our leaders, Lord, in this church, God. Thank you, Lord, for sending people to this church who are after your heart, Lord. We know when we're after your heart, we're after the heart of the lost. God, we thank you, Lord, for people who were filled with your spirit, oh God. People, dear God, who hunger to be filled with your spirit, who thirst to be filled with you, Lord. Father, we only want to be imitators of you, Lord. We just want to imitate you, God. Imitate your word in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for spiritual fathers, spiritual leaders, people we can look at and look upon, God, and who are holding your hand, Lord, that's teaching us how to hold your hand. God, thank you for those in our lives that make us love you more, make us desire you more. Thank you for the prayers of the righteous that availeth much, God. Prayers that are changing the landscape of our city, God. Thank you, Lord, for prayers that are being heard on high, being answered by you, Lord. Prayers that you are answering and moving on, God. God, we thank you, Lord, that we know that you hear our prayers and answer them. We thank you for saving souls. We thank you for turning the hearts of the unbeliever around, dear God, turning them towards you, and the backslider's hearts being turned back to you, Lord. Thank you, God, for all of you being in us, dear God, and we want all of you in us, Lord. Thank you for the revival that's coming, Lord. Thank you for the revival smell that's in the air of this ministry, God. That's in the words of this ministry, God. We smell revival. We sense it. We can taste it, oh God. And Father, it tastes so good, Lord. It tastes so good when we're doing what you've called us to do. Now, Lord, we give you praise and honor, Lord, as we testify of your goodness, testify of revival, and as we hear your word on tonight, Lord. As we draw closer to you, Lord, we just give you praise and honor and glory in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Listen, before you have a seat, amen, if you have a prayer language, amen, go and join somebody's hands. If you got a prayer language, go and join somebody else's hand. We're going to pray in the spirit. Amen. Paul said, I pray at will. Amen. There's no feeling that comes over you to pray. You can pray all the time in the spirit. So go and find somebody that you can join hands with. And we're going to pray in the spirit. Amen. I want you to pray in the spirit. Praise God. Amen. To God, and people may not understand it, and that's okay, But God understands it. And when we stop to pray in the spirit and we stop to understand why we're doing it, then we give reverence to God. There is a time when you speak in the spirit, and when speaking in the spirit, God gives an interpretation. He gives direction from speaking in the spirit. It's different to speak in the spirit than to pray in the spirit. Whenever we speak in the spirit, God will always give someone or even to that person who is speaking the ability to interpret what the Lord has said. Amen. God hasn't changed. He still has his own language. And a language that he understands, a language that's not for you or I to understand. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. I'm so happy and thankful, amen, to be the pastor of Abounding Grace. The pastor, amen. Amen. The pastor, people who love the Lord and who are hard to after the Lord. Amen. We don't come to this place just to be entertained, or we come to grow. We come to be edified. Amen. We come to be perfected. We come, amen, to shed off whatever we have to shed off and to walk in the spirit. I believe this with all my heart, and I say this from the spirit of the Lord, that the Lord has called this church and this body of believers to do something miraculous in this time. Amen.
Amen.
He didn't just call us to assemble and call us to be like everybody else. We're not like everybody else. We're different than other people. Amen. I believe we're everything that God wants us to be. And I can't help everybody else in getting the same message that we're getting here, amen, and understanding the same thing that God wants us to understand here, amen. But that's okay. We're going to continue to do what God is calling us to do and be a light in darkness, amen. I still believe that this church on the corner of Robertson Hollywood is a lighthouse. Amen. I still believe that it represents, amen, praise God. Praise God. I believe it represents a Jordan River kind of place, amen. A place, amen. Jordan River wasn't a place. It's a place that spoke about a lot in the Bible, but it's a whole lot of other rivers that are more attractive than the Jordan River. It's a whole lot of other rivers around that people would choose to go to. They wouldn't choose to go to the Jordan River because it simply wasn't a nice river. And it was other rivers that were cleaner and nicer and more attractive, amen. Probably were beautiful, amen. If you were back then and you were gonna have a picnic, you probably wouldn't go to the Jordan River to have that picnic. You would probably go somewhere else. But it was the Jordan River where Jesus was baptized. It was the Jordan River where John the Baptist did a lot of his work, amen. And it was the Jordan River where Naaman, when he was diseased with leprosy, where the prophet told him to go and dip. He went and dipped in the Jordan River. And it was Naaman, who was wealthy and well off, that said, well, you know, there's other places to go other than the Jordan River. Why? The old nasty Jordan River. And when he went home and the little servant girl said to him, you know, if they would have told you to do this, you would have done this. And so Naaman, he followed what the prophet said, and he went and he dipped 7 times in the Jordan River, the old nasty Jordan River, the old unattractive Jordan River. And he came up out of that river clean. Amen. Amen. And I believe that this church is like a Jordan River. That it is not as attractive as a lot of other churches, and it's not in the community where a lot of other churches are, in affluent communities, but it's in a place, amen, that when people come here, they're going to dip in this water, that this living water of Abounding Grace Amen. And they're going to walk out of here healed, delivered, set free, and made whole. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. I just believe that God's going to bring the city of Shreveport to Roberts and Hollywood. I believe that. I believe he's going to bring the city of Shreveport to this place. And people are going to look for places to go. And they're going to go and they're going to find where the power of God is. And the power of God is going to be here. And this place is going to be a light. And it's going to be a light. It's already a light. And people are going to see the light. And they're going to be drawn to here. Amen. People are already drawn to here. Amen. And they're going to be drawn to here. Black people, white people, Asian people. Amen. Lost people, saved people. Amen. They're going to be drawn to here. And the reason they're going to be drawn is because of the Spirit of God that's in you. Amen. Not the Spirit of God only that's in the pastor, but the Spirit of God that's in the believers of this ministry. Amen. And when they come in here, they're going to come in and they're going to be set free. They're going to hear a word that they hadn't heard before. And they're going to believe again about Jesus loving them, amen, and Jesus caring for them, amen. And their life is going to change and they're going to be revived. Amen. Amen. Do y'all believe that? Amen. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. It's going to happen. Praise God. It is going to happen. To God be the glory, is going to happen. I want to thank you for blessing me and my family with those love gifts. Amen. After the revival, so unexpected, but so thankful. Amen. For you doing what you did. I tell you, you did above and beyond. Amen. And it was truly a blessing. And seeds were still coming in on Sunday. Amen. And I say, man, you cannot be God-given no matter how you try. Amen. Amen. No matter how you try, you cannot be how good God is and how God wants to bless you and keep blessing you. And I tell you this, you bless the man of God. And God, when you bless me out of your heart, God turn around and bless you. I'm telling you, that's what you do, amen. Amen. When you are a blessing, amen, to the one that treads the corn, amen, and God turns around and he bless you, amen. Praise God. That's just how he do it. That's just how he do it, amen. Praise God. I just wanted a couple of testimonies before we talk tonight about the revival. If anybody says, hey, I tell you, my life was changed from the revival. Amen. I just want you to stand and share that. Amen. With us on tonight. Amen. Praise God. Just stand and Brother Dre will bring you the mic. Amen. And to God be the glory. Amen. Not everybody at one time. I know everybody here wants to say something. Amen. But amen. Praise God. Let the devil break that book.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. I just want to say that before the revival, and even when you first called for it, I understood in me that I truly needed a revival. You pray. Okay. But like you said before, it ain't like when you know that you need to be revived. So when I was thanking God that he already set in motion what we desire. He said he gives you desires of your heart. And when you desire more, God, I want to get back where I want to get beyond where I used to be. I want to get further than where I used to go. So I already knew that it was coming. So I'm thankful that during the revival and even just prior to it, there was a lot of prayer going on. Prayer for the revival, prayer in the revival. And even in therein, I seen the prayers of the righteous, the growth in the prayers of the righteous. It was just so amazing to me, and it revived me even before the revival started. So there in the revival, I just got a double portion of blessing from being revived. And I can say now that I feel God's presence in the prayers. I feel God's anointing when we speak, when we pray in the spirit, in the tongue. I can feel it. And even over the sanctuaries, it was just amazing. If you could just remove yourself and just take a moment to look. I was sitting back there and I was just recording. I felt bad at first because I couldn't join in. I was like, I wanted to be touched like that. But it was just, I could see the presence of God just swarming through. It was just like circling and moving. And I knew that that was the spirit of God of revival in all of us. And I just want to say thank God for revival. We are truly revived. I am truly revived. And I'm thankful for the revival. Amen.
Man, since I got the mic, I might as well give me a little bit of that. Well, I just want to say that the revival definitely blessed me and blessed my family. I tell you, I'm just revived. I knew I needed it. It's like you're saying, bro, you be knowing you need it. It don't mean I didn't got that far away from God. I'm right here, I'm still in Christ, but I want that burning desire back, that zeal for you, God. And I know right now, man, I'm just on fire for the Lord. Me and my wife both, we talk about it. And, man, even our marriage is just took off to a whole other level. And I'm just so grateful. And I know it's a revival. Amen.
Spiritually at all, and that's where I was at. And just like, you know, you wake up in the morning and you don't read, it's not that it's not okay, but you just kind of go about your day, and you know, and you just get in a cycle like, oh, I feel like I'm far away from God, even though He's always there, you know. So to be honest, coming to the revival, I had expectation, but maybe not so much for me, maybe for other people to be revived and for people to be healed. But for myself, just being in the revival, it's like I got revived myself and what people expected. And like they said, it's what I needed. And I just had this song that kept playing in my head, I won't go back. I can't go back to the way it used to be before your presence came and changed me. And that's exactly what His presence does every single time. Changes me. So I'm excited about the 7-day revival that's coming up. And I can't wait to be even more refreshed and to go higher and higher.
Wow, the revival. You can smile and almost seem like the light to others, but on the inside you know that there's something. You know you desire more. You know that God desires more from you. You get busy with life and with raising kids and being a wife, and you know, you work. You get so busy and consumed with so many other things, and knowing that you need it, but you don't know where to start. So when you call for it, I remember the leaders preparing, and then it was just like, no, we're going to do it. And then me just being like, are we ready? Are we ready? But it's not about being ready. It's about just going and doing it and seeing the manifestation of it. And during the revival, I just realized that I was heavy. And I've been that way for so long, not realizing that the joy that I once had, that I didn't have it anymore. That it was almost like just a shade of, I can put on a smile and I can be, you know, try to be delightful for others, love on people, but still not really fulfilled. So knowing that the singing, the praying, all of that during the revival, it was part of it. But not only that, but like I was telling my husband today, you have to go take your revival because it's a state of being. It's not just being revived and feeling a certain way every day coming into the revival, but taking that because that's a state of everyday being. And I'm revived. Even with realizing that the pain of rheumatoid arthritis, like realizing I hadn't felt that pain or that discomfort in so long. And today, for some reason, you know the reason, but I started feeling achy again and tired and just worn down. And normally, that would make me feel like I need to stay home because I don't know if I can handle the babies and doing all of this and coming home afterwards and taking care of what I need to take care of. But because I know that it's a state of being, I pressed because I need to be here. And not only being here, but I know that that's a press. And so that's my being.
That's right.
So. Okay.
Praise God. I just thank God just for from that first Sunday being healed in my body from a nerve issue to my relationship with God being changed. Before, it felt like I was taking a bunch of 5-hour energies, and I would get a jolt, and I would be close to God, and then die off. I'd get another jolt, die off. But through that revival, God, like He showed everybody else, He's trying to show us sustainability, and what revival did was it gave us sustainability, and it's going to keep us this time. There ain't no going, like I said, ain't no going back. God has showed me some real things through this revival, being a better husband, better father, being a better leader in this ministry. He didn't just touch one thing. He's like, look, I want you to be this way in every area, and I'm going to help you be that way, and through the revival, God has done that for me.
Amen.
This church that I joined, I think it'd been more than a week ago, but I thank God for change, brokenness, and growth, because I want to get back to the place I once was in Him, and for me to be able to still seek Him when He's still there, and I thought I was just so far away from Him. Oh, I just thank You, Lord God. Amen. So I thank You for the revival. Amen.
I want to say glory to God, because what He did for me was He awakened me even more. You know what the desire should do, what needs to be done as a believer. You know, we can walk around and portray to be one way and say things and do things, but when you're true after God's heart, man, He will awaken every aspect of your life.
Amen.
When you desire to follow Him. And that's what He did for me. He truly woke me up, you know what I mean? Every inch of me. And now my desire is to be more for Him. You know, everything, every other aspect of life don't even matter.
Yeah.
So now it's about God's business and nothing else.
Amen.
That's what He did for me.
Praise God, everybody. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Revival, revival, revival. That's what I'm texting on Facebook when Pastor was doing the live broadcast. Truly, this revival has been second to none. It has blessed my family, blessed me. Let me start with me first. Hallelujah. I thank and I praise God as Brother Dennis was saying before the revival even begun. God had revived me through the fasting, through the reading of the word, you know, and the praying. I mean, praying daily, you know, coming in here on Monday and Friday, you know, and not only here, but it's nothing like being in the house of the Lord. But, you know, I pray at home, you know, all the time, all during the day. But here, being in the house of the Lord, revival had already started before revival came. And when I got up to pray, I thank God because He gave me that the house is now ready. So I just thank God for the house being now ready. But I want to share this real quickly with you. On past revivals, you know, we've had that opportunity. I think we had one last year in May. And God blesses. He's always blessing His people. But I'm always praying for souls to be saved. That's my desire, for people to be saved. So on this revival, you know, I usually pray for the people, Lord save. Lord save, Lord. Lord save, Lord. Lord heal. Lord deliver. Lord bless, you know. So I heard somebody say, and I'm not going to call no names, say, you got to pray for the people to come.
You got to pray for the Lord to bring the people to this place. So I start praying for God to bring people here. And I tell you, people came. When I looked around, I saw people that I had never seen before. People just was coming in. I thank God for being a God of His Word, because He did bring the people. Not only that, that He revived me. But when we got together as a body corporately, oh man, He just overflooded. And I just thank God for the revival, and I thank Him for what He's continue to do. I want to share in the revival, not only did people get healed, not only did people get delivered and set free, but I want to thank and praise God for two of my family members received salvation. I'm crying out for your family. Yeah. I'm crying out for your family. I'm crying out for the neighborhood. I'm crying out for our city, for our state. You know, I'm praying that God, you know, save, just like He said He would, and He can and He will. So I thank God for what He did for my family. And I told somebody, that's just two of them. There's so many more to go. But I thank God He snatched those two out. I thank and I praise God for how He's working in me. I think I told a couple of ladies that I was supposed to go to Mega Fest. And I was supposed to leave here like on Wednesday. And I had already taken off days for the beat and the revival. Because how many of you know if you're looking for God to do something for you, you're going to have to do something for Him. You're going to have to make some sacrifices. So I did some changing in my schedule. I took off work, you know, because I know if I take care of God's business, He will take care of my business. So I took off for the revival. Then I was supposed to leave on Wednesday morning. But the pastor called for Wednesday night revival, and I certainly went about to leave then, because I tell you, God blessed us here on Tuesday night, and on Wednesday night, He came back and swept the house, hallelujah, and I think on that night was when I got a call, and I went to, you know, to the hospital to deal with a family member and so forth, but I just want to say God is so good, and I thank and I praise God for speaking to me and giving me ears to hear what He is saying to me, because after that, I go like, what I'm going to Dallas to Mega Fest for? I got everything I need right here in this house. So thank God for the revival that took place here, and thank God for the revival. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Come on, give the saints a hand of praise.